Hello. How are you? What's your name?
Hey, what's up, player?
Oh.
It's good, dog.
Oh.
How you doing? You see my ring?
Yeah.
Hands so yellow like with that her. Voice.
yellow for that
whole thing. Yellow, man.
The yellow hand with a different voice.
Start the episode, man.
Oh, I am starting. That's why I'm asking you questions and just want to get to know you.
Who called me yellow?
Did you guys ever watch that children's show? They put eyeballs here.
Sock? That, I used to hate that fool.
Yeah. Oh, look at that. Anthony Lee is here.
I hate puppet shows. Damn. Dang, you didn't even like Mr. Rogers or anything? With like Daniel that used to piss me off, man.
Like Elmo, Sesame Street?
Well, that's different. That's legit.
That's like the...
Oh, like the TV puppet shows are okay.
Kermit the Frog.
Sock puppets is what you...
Sock puppets and like the string puppets and like...
The
marionettes?
That's what they're called. Marion.
Oh, they were so ugly? Yeah.
Well, don't worry, Joe.
You didn't like Pinocchio?
I'm gonna save you, Joe. You know why? Because this story has nothing to do with
Thank God.
So this story actually involves a luxury hotel that's opening.
Oh, I want a hotel.
Where?
In South Africa.
Oh, I like South Africa.
And it's this unique luxury resort that sits partially on a historic bridge that's over a river in Kruger National Park.
I only know Cape Town.
This is what it looks like.
It's a broken train on a bridge?
So this train permanently sits on this train track now.
Oh, it's broken.
But back in the day, they used to come into this bridge and then they would station there for like a night or a couple nights.
On the bridge?
Yeah, on the bridge. And then like people would like go and explore whatever, so explore the park and then like come back and then the train will leave. But now this train.
It's never leaving.
That's cool.
My question is, what if they need to deliver something and another train comes and they're like, sorry, we're just parked here forever. And they're like, fuck man, how are we gonna get these bananas to Cape Town and shit?
You know, they didn't think of that.
Yep.
They really didn't consider that.
And the other train that's coming is like a freshly new renovated train hotel. Yeah. She's like, get out the way, old guy.
Dang, look at that shit, that's a train.
So it has 24 carriage rooms.
I like that.
It's crazy nice.
Yeah, and then did you guys notice what's hanging off the side?
What?
That's a jacuzzi. So you could be in the jacuzzi fishing at the same time.
Yeah, because they're saying underneath the train, because like I said, it's over a river. That's Weaver. Where you could see like hippos and like.
Whoa! Don't catch a hippo.
So it's like an exotic river. It's got like exotic animals.
It's a park. It's a national park. Yeah. Kruger National
hippos
Park.
Hippos are pretty cute, but did you know they're ferocious?
One of the most ferocious animals.
I see Instagram videos of them all the time crushing watermelons in their like fucked up teeth.
Yeah.
They only got 4 teeth.
They wiggle the ears though.
Yeah. With a little tail, when there's a fly on it, they shake it out.
Well, tell me about crocodiles then. Because you could also see crocodiles and also buffaloes. And elephants?
Book? They got book? I didn't know Africa had buffaloes.
Yep.
Oh, we're talking about Lion King buffaloes. I was thinking American bison.
Like water buffaloes, probably.
Yeah, those guys, they're not that cute.
Oh.
What?
But the American ones are cute?
American ones are cute.
Like the ones you used to shoot on Oregon Trail? Buffalo.
That's just the shit.
Yeah, so like I said, you know how I said like back in the day they would park and stuff? That was in the early 1920s.
They would leave the train on the bridge and then people would just walk off on the bridge and walk around?
This
doesn't seem very
safe. They didn't care about safety back then.
Maybe they walk from one car to the other car.
Like the Hogwarts Express?
Maybe there's one end. Oh, because back then they knew how to fly broomsticks, so they just jumped off of the train and then they flew.
Probably.
Yep.
Different broomsticks, but yes.
Yeah, that's true. It's just a theme of the broomstick ride, yeah.
Yeah, so they're also saying that, so they have the Big Five at this park.
Sporting goods?
Lions, leopards, rhinos, elephants, and African buffaloes.
Wait, there's a Big Five?
I don't know if I want to go camping in Africa.
Oh shit.
Because they would hunt the Big Five?
Originally it was a hunting store.
Is that why it's called Big Five?
Maybe.
But what is the Big Five again?
Why is Target called Target?
I thought it was
just to shoot them.
I thought it was because it's like football, soccer, basketball. Football.
Football twice. Or Hunting, maybe?
I don't know, yeah. Oh, it's about, because if you go in the Big Five, what do you got? You got the fucking bodyboards, you got the shoes, you got the baseball, soccer.
Some clearance Nike items.
Hunting shit.
I mean, they got everything, but everything kind of sucks a little bit.
You got like work / dress shoes in the back.
Yeah, you can't get dress shoes too.
They're like work dress shoes.
You got a lot of knives. A
lot of knives. Couple baseball tees.
I'm down with that. Fishing stuff. Fishing stuff?
Not a lot of fishing stuff. I used to work at Big Five. It's my second job ever.
Big League Chew. You
know where the name comes from.
Yeah, giraffes, football, football, soccer, football.
Nice. But yeah.
Yeah, when I hear that, I'm like, man, I forget how there's so many predators, like animals in the, we just gotta watch out for like bears, right? So out here, I'm just like, I'll go camping. Cause when am I gonna run into
but
like
you're in a
bear?
Train here.
No, but like when I hear that, I'm like, I wanted to go camping in Africa, but I forgot they got lions. They got tigers.
That's why you gotta go on like a safari where you don't actually camp, but you stay in like a cage and then you just like take videos of people either or like animals either eating each other or like having
people
sex.
Eating each other?
But I wanna like camp, like in a tent.
Or you gotta pitch a tent in like a tree where only a giraffe who's like a herbivore can sit.
Jaguars climb trees, dude.
Fuck, bro, you're making it difficult right now. What do you want?
Have you guys seen that one?
Gorillas climb trees.
Then stay in a train, Joe. Just stay in a luxury hotel train.
Nah, but the hippo's gonna jump up and get him on the broomstick.
So, in case you guys were wondering, the prices start, like the rates, they start from about $520 per night per person.
Oh, damn,
it
that's
includes
expensive.
Meals, house drinks, and 2 daily game drives for you to go out and see animals.
A safari?
Yeah.
No thanks.
And then so, okay, well don't worry, Joe. They made it for other people too. So.
Why don't you want to go on the safaris?
It's so expensive.
Oh. He's trying to camp out there in the perfect place where gorillas and jaguars can't get you.
Gotcha.
You have gorillas now?
Okay,
there's
picture this.
There, right?
You go out, 10 ways to die from an animal. You're riding a golf cart, right? You pay $500 to risk your life. Come on, that doesn't sound like a deal to me.
$440?
Hell yeah.
Talking different story.
But $500? Come on, man. You're out there, it's a safari ride. Fuck that, I'd rather go to Disneyland where it's safe. And then they fucking do the blow darts at you. And you gotta
the
go
jungle
like,
cruise?
Oh shit, yeah, the jungle
cruise. Electric animals.
Unless they improve them like that robotic dolphin we saw.
Oh yeah.
That'd be tight.
Yeah. I'm down with that.
So the resort's name is Kruger.
The dude's not trying to get bit by the crocodile.
Oh yeah.
He's just going up and down.
Yeah.
That's pretty good. But yeah, the name of this place is called Kruger Shalati. And Shalati is the name of an African warrior queen who, according to the legend, was one of the first female warrior chiefs of the small Tabula clan, part of the Tsonga tribe that lived in the bush around there. And so, yeah, they're saying that the national park itself, the Kruger National Park, is one of the largest game reserves in all of Africa, covering 2 million hectares? How do you say that?
Hectares.
No, wait, no.
It's not hectares?
It's hectares.
It's like acres, right?
Yeah, it's like oh yeah, you're right, hectares. I thought you were kidding. But yeah, you're right.
Oh. You literally 2 no, million Mexicans in the whole
house. That's why I thought he was kidding.
2 million, man. Hey, we can see if we can fit one more. Hectares. 2 million, 1 hectares? Nah.
How do they measure it? Oh, they just used to get 50 Mexican guys and they're like,
same hectare.
That's 50 hectares right there.
Oh, shit.
Okay. How about acres? They just got a bunch of Irish guys or something. I don't know.
Okay. There's a shortage of hectares all over the world.
That's fucking funny. Anyway, so it's filled with hundreds of animal species as well as cultural heritage and archaeological Stone Age sites. So it sounds like a cool place to go. I really want to visit it.
That's a 50-hectare farm right there. They have to travel in like big buses.
I know.
Cause they're getting a land survey and shit where they're dividing up the land. How much is this piece of property? 20 hectares.
Bring in the hectares.
Bring them in. Goes, they all assemble.
Actually, it's 17.
It's 18 hectares.
Stupid.
You know, there's a difference between acres and hectares. Yes. I forgot what it was.
Metric. It's hectares are the metric.
Metric version
it's
of
for
it.
For the British?
Well, like the metric system. It's
for the Mexicans. It's for the Spanish.
Yeah, so it says...
Oh, fuck.
So it is a metric unit of square measure equal to 100 yep. eras, which is 2.4 acres or 10,000 square meters.
How do you spell
hectares? I don't know any of those.
H-E... C T A R E.
Hectares.
Hectares. Hectares. A fucking half Mexican, half bull.
Hectares. It's like a centaur.
Yes. Mexican mythology.
Wait, is he Mexican from the waist down?
I don't know.
I'm dying. His waist down. It's like a cholo with shorts that go to his ankles and he's wearing Cortez.
But it's a
and it's a horse at the top.
No, that's Mexican American. Different culture.
Sorry. All right. It's a guy with cowboy boots and a long
snake boots. Snake skin boots.
And a big Mexican flag belt.
Someone got to draw a hectare and tag me, dude.
Yo. But like hundreds of them holding hands across South Africa.
Yeah. 2 million hectares.
So dumb.
Oh my god. And the visual is so strong in my head.
Yeah, I picture they all have to have mustaches too. Yeah.
Hello guys, thank you guys so much for watching all of our videos, and I know it's been a million years in the making, but we finally got Just Kidding News merch.
Yep.
So make sure you go down to the store below. And you can, get a piece of JK News. And thank you guys for supporting.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.